Namhlanje on the Gadget Show, you can anticipate seeing the BMW M3 for the car for the day. And then we're going to find out to what gadget are we having a look at. And then of course we cross over to Umhlaba Omnandi wama video game. We have a look and find out to who the celebrity viewer for the day is. The robotic for the day is Honda Asimo. We'll find out more about that. And then of course we wrap up the show with the social link, Kuzuva Mnandi. Ladies and gentlemen, my nene guys, it is about that time. Again, we call it the Gadget Show, right here on channel 251 Soweto TV. It's all about the games, the gadgets, and the technology, and you and I interacting right here on your favorite channel. With that being said, a formal introduction. I am the dude with the face for radio and the voice for TV. Marvelous Wonder is the name. And of course, putting a smile on your face is the game. And for the next few moments, and you will be spending some time looking at the latest cars, the latest technology, gadgets, and reviews. You don't get into that, happens to be in between as well. So, on social media, Facebook, Twitter, and everything else, that it's about that time. We are back, baby. We are on a good system because it's about moving. With that being said, let us check out the car for the week. Namhlanje. I'm running around my Kusheshe. Of course, it is the modern day Kusheshe. The BMW M3 is a high performance version of the BMW 3 Series, developed by BMW's in-house motorsports division, the BMW M. M3 models are sold with coupe, saloon, and convertible body styles, konislahla, konefemil, and konitudor, in other words. And the last M3 coupe, the two-door version, was produced in Germany on the 5th of July in 2013. And right now, it's being replaced by the M4 coupe, starting with the 2015 model year. And don't worry though, the M3 will actually still remain there, but it will only be for the family version, which is the saloon version of the car, and all the rest will just be M4. So it's gonna be Kusheshe 4, something like that. M3 is a legend in the world of performance cars. Obviously, it needs no introduction. It's got a history spanning back in the day, and ekudala abantu bahlanyisa with the twin turbo 3-liter inline six that makes 425 horsepower. To help you avoid confusion, the M3 badge is now applied only to sedan models. The coupe and convertible models now wear the new M4 designation. M4, boy. Kusase M3 lendule. M4. Kusheshe. Alright, let's get to the technicalities. The top speed it will reach is 260 kilometers an hour. 0 to 100 kilometers will be reached in 4.1 seconds. Nyofika manje eKapa, boy. And the price you can expect to pay for this brand new baby, fresh from the box, minimum 1.3 million rand. You. Start saving kona manje. It is time for us to give you the star rating, namhlanje, and the BMW M3 receives a star rating of 8.5. Danke, boy. Welcome back to it, ladies and gentlemen, my nene guys. You are tuned into the Gadget Show. It's the awesomest, the best show on channel 251 on TV. That is exactly why we're bringing you the latest, the awesomest stories when it comes to cars, technology, video games, and yonke into esithanda ukuyidobetha kanjalo. And with that being said, just to give you some random facts, did you know that there's actually more than a billion cars in the world? More than a billion cars in the world. That means out of 7 billion people, 1 billion people are driving, or at least own cars. So 1 out of 7, as in, ngikhuluma too much. That is a random fact. But right now, please do me a favor, ladies and gentlemen, and check out our gadget for the week. It's Katsik Gadget Review Kona Manje right here on the Gadget Show. And Kona Manje, we're looking at something that angizazi mina lezinto lezi. As much as I'm into gadgets, I'm into video games and stuff like that, but I think it's perfect for uneo asichazisele kabanzi ukuthi what is overclocking. Sharp kunjani boza?
Sharp.
Overclocking, I see you busy here. I'm seeing temperatures going down. What is it exactly?
It's basically making your computer go as fast as possible.
right? And to achieve a certain goal, it's a number. You run benchmarks to find out who can be the highest, who can score the highest, right, in the specific benchmark, and that's it.
So what, is that part of the competition for overclocking or something?
That's the only competition it is, overclocking.
Besides, before we get into the competition, yeah, overclocking on a personal note, if Mina Mumbugulo Sekhaya, I'm the viewer, and I want to do this for myself, why would I be doing it?
Well, there are different levels of overclocking. There's competitive overclocking, and then there's just general overclocking for gamers. Yeah. So if you can't afford a computer that's 10,000 Rand, yeah, you can buy a computer that's 6,000 Rand and make it perform like a 10,000 Rand computer. You see what I'm saying?
So it's almost like in terms of cars, you know, pimp my ride kind of vibe. So you're pimping your computer, you're pimping it for the performance of, you know, improving your video gaming experience.
Exactly, that's just how it is. So if you don't have the money or the resources are tight for the moment, you can just overclock a little bit, get better performance out of it. We take it to the next level, we do it competitively. We don't do it for gaming. We just do it to go as fast as possible. We're drag racing computers, basically.
I like that. They like drag racing in terms of computers. So how does it work? What do you have in this flask over here? And what are you pouring inside it? Why are you pouring it? Explain the process.
Okay, so what I have in here is liquid nitrogen. It gets very cold. I think it's minus 196 degrees. Woo! Right? Yeah. But we obviously are not going to go that low because the system is going to crash if you go that low, right? So we usually cool the system down to a minus 100 or minus 130 degrees, depending on the system, right? And once we have it there, you can make it go as fast as possible, right?
Pouring this nitrogen inside there, what happens then?
It cools down the entire system. Any computer component, the cooler it is, the better it performs, right? So we want to get it as cool as possible so that we can make it clock as high as possible.
What, does it spread throughout the whole motherboard system or something?
Only for the central processing unit, just for the CPU only, right?
And what, can I do this by myself without being trained or something?
If you read enough, yeah, you can do it yourself, right? You start slowly, you start just water cooling, you start air cooling, and then you graduate to dry ice, which is readily available anywhere, and then you move on to liquid nitrogen when you are ready to take the next step.
Where do I find the dry ice, the nitrogen, where do I find this stuff?
You can find dry ice at a place called Dry Ice International. They can deliver to you, or you can go and fetch it yourself. They have outlets throughout South Africa, actually, right? It's relatively cheap. It's much cheaper than getting this. I think this is a 35 rand a liter or something like that. It's really, really expensive. But dry ice is so much cheaper, and it can get you quite far, because dry ice goes up to, or down to, minus 79 degrees centigrade or something.
In terms of the competitiveness of overclocking, Lana Mzansi, how big is it compared to the rest of the world?
The overclocking community is relatively small here. I mean, we all know each other, competitive overclockers. I know the guy across from there. I know the other guy there. I know him. We've known each other for years. So it's friends who just get together, overclock, compete sometimes against each other. Sometimes they're on the same team, right? So it's just camaraderie and just basically helping each other out, get better, competing with the international guys. So I know two of our South African overclockers, the best overclockers we've had in South Africa, are competing next week in Taipei, Taiwan, for the overclocking competition.
Right here on the Gadget Show, we cater for everyone, the hardcore people that are into, you know, the CPU system and the hardcore gaming, and of course people like me that are just the consumer level people. I just want a PC, I just want a laptop. Overclocking for what? I've got my watch right here. Anyway, Newo, thank you so much for the time, and good luck with all the competitions across the globe and locally as well, yeah?
Yeah, thank you guys for spreading the word on overclocking. Hopefully we get the young people involved, right? See more of them next year here.
They're watching the Gadget Show.
Yeah, I hope they are, right? Watch.
Wait, my clock is over. Welcome back to it, ladies and gentlemen, manene guys. You're still tuned into Channel 251. It is the Gadget Show. Now, before we get to the ad break, I gotta tell you something important. The first mouse invented was invented back in 1964. Igundwane, one of the computer, yasebenzisa to direct and navigate through the screen. It was invented back in 1964. That is incredible. Salowe si kula kanjalo, and ekhona manje wamele ukuthi siphume kancane. City ad break. We'll be back after this.